So you want to get a divorce, but your spouse lives out of country. What do you do? Hello everybody, my name is Daniel Wiapi, and I am the president and the director of marketing of Vegas Divorce Pros out here in beautiful and sunny, warm Las Vegas. And as I record this video, it's actually not that sunny and it's not that warm, but usually it is. But anyways, we are not attorneys. We are licensed document preparers who are licensed by the state to prepare and file your divorce at a very, very low cost, at the fraction of the price of a typical Las Vegas attorney. If you are needing help with a divorce, an annulment, legal separation, or any other type of legal need, please feel free to go to the link that is right below my finger at VegasDivorcePros.com. That being said, you guys, none of the information on this video or any of our other media shall be construed as legal advice. Now, answering that question, what to do if your husband, your wife, your significant other, your baby's mama is out of the country and you need to get a divorce, all right? So you guys, we get that type of scenario with our clients pretty much on a weekly basis, okay? And the basic thing that you want to make sure is you want to make sure that if your spouse does live in another country, let's say they're in Mexico, let's say they're in Kenya, let's say they're in Israel or wherever, right? You want to try to get them to actually sign and notarize the divorce documents where they're at, because that will make the process a lot simpler, quicker, easier, and cheaper, all right? So what's going to need to happen, you guys, is in the scenario where they are going to sign the papers and they are willing to sign it, then what you're going to typically want to do is do what is called a joint petition divorce. That is our uncontested divorce paperwork that we prepare for our clients. Both parties are going to need to sign and notarize. What we do with our clients when they are out of the country, you guys, is we are going to go ahead and email them the PDF documents, and then they are going to actually sign and notarize the documents in their home country. Now, the thing is, you want to make sure that whoever is the notary that is notarizing their documents, you want to make sure that it's in English, okay? So if you're in a country, like let's say your spouse is in China or Turkey or Russia or somewhere else, right? Your typical notary out there, they're not gonna know English, are they? So what you're going to wanna do is go to an English notary or perhaps an American embassy, which in some countries, it can be a little bit difficult to do that, okay? But whatever the case is, you need to get somebody that's English to notarize the documents, okay? Now, you can also use what is called an e-notary, and that's something that the state of Nevada has started to allow the past year and a half, 2 years, I believe it is, okay, since about 2018, 2019. And basically, you can pay somebody 40, 50 bucks or more, and they'll go ahead and get your spouse on video camera, and then your spouse will need to show them their government-issued ID, right, passport, driver's license, whatnot, to verify their identity, and then the e-notary will go ahead and notarize the documents, okay? So that is also another option that's available for you, all right? Now, if your spouse is not willing to sign the papers, or if you have a spouse that's overseas in another country, and they're the type of people that kind of drag their feet, and you can't really trust them once you send the divorce papers, then you may not want to do a joint petition, okay? What you may want to do is do a complaint for divorce and then serve them, okay, in another country. The only issue with that is you want to get a licensed process server or a sheriff or a private investigator in that other country to serve the papers to that spouse, okay? Or do a publication divorce if you're not sure where the whereabouts of your spouse is, okay? But as you guys can see, there is literally a million and one different scenarios that can take place when you do have a spouse, a husband, a wife, a baby's mama that lives in another country and you want to get a Nevada divorce, okay? So even though the steps are a bit more, I don't want to say complicated, but it's there's a little bit more work that needs to be done on those. It's not impossible, okay? And so what you want to do is make sure you guys go to the link Stop playing around. VegasDivorcePros.com. We're going to give you a free 15-minute phone consultation. We can talk about your case, see how we can help you. So anyways, peace and God bless you guys. I will see you at the top. Stay warm.